I'm Alexis Van Hurkman, and welcome to Resolve in a Rush, where you'll learn DaVinci Resolve grading and finishing techniques in under 5 minutes. In this episode, we're going to take a look at how you can create animated titles inside of DaVinci Resolve without having to go to any other app to do it. So let's get started. If I open up the toolbox, and you can see I've got some title pages that I can pull up. These are simple generators. So I'll edit two of them into the timeline. And if I double click any of these, I go straight to the inspector. I will edit the text with the title of this project. An Unwanted Job is the name of the project. And so now selecting each one of these items in the timeline, as long as I have my transform handles turned on in the viewer, I can go ahead and just drag these around wherever I want them to be. And with each one of these objects selected, I can go over here and select the text and change the font to something a little more inspiring. Change the size, all the standard stuff that you can do. So now I've got a pretty good start on my title sequence, but of course it's not yet animated. So I'm going to go to the frame where I want this text to stop moving. And if I scroll down in the inspector, you can see that I have all my composite and transform controls handy. So what I'm going to do is keyframe pan and tilt. That's X and Y. I'm going to select this item and maybe offset the animation a little bit. And again, I'm going to scroll down and I'm going to keyframe pan and tilt. Now, once keyframing is started for both of these layers, all I need to do is move my playhead to the beginning here and drag these layers where I want them to fly in from. And now as I play, I've got my animation. Now I don't have caching turned on just yet, so my performance isn't great, but you can see I've got the animation that I want. Now by default, this is a simple linear animation, so if I want to jazz this up a little bit, I can click these little handles on the video tracks. I'll shrink the video tracks down just a little bit. I don't need them to be this tall. And when I do that, you can see I expose my keyframe editors. If I click the little curve button inside of the keyframe editor, now I've got a curve editor. And inside of the curve editor, I can select any point and set it to be a Bezier handle to create some smooth motion. And I'm going to do that in the bottommost piece of text as well. So I'll select the keyframe, I'll click the Bezier handle button to turn this into an incoming smoothed keyframe. And now you can see I have some nice eased motion. I want to make sure that I get both keyframes eased, and to do that, I have a little pop-out menu up there that lets me choose which curve I'm looking at. And I want to do the same thing up here. Just toggle those off and on so I can see the other curve. So once I've added handles to both X and Y, I can see that I've got my sequence just easing into a stop. At this point, I can close the editors. If I hold the Shift key, I can drag these up without moving them. And then I can go in here and try and find that nice opening shot that I had before. Grab that car, coming in underneath, and you can see how those titles integrate with the rest of the scene. Now at this point, if I want those to fade away, I can cheese out, just add a couple fast dissolves. Or, if I really wanted to be fancy, I could go back into the inspector and using keyframes, I could simply animate the opacity handle for both of those. I hope you found this useful. If you want more information on working in the edit page of DaVinci Resolve, I strongly suggest you check out my Editing in DaVinci Resolve 11 title from Ripple Training. Thanks so much for watching.